गुड मॉर्निंग कैडेट्स, इन दिस लॉकडाउन आई थॉट ऑफ गोइंग थ्रू सम ऑफ द इंट्रोडक्शंस ऑफ एनसीसी, द थियोरेटिकल पार्ट ऑफ एनसीसी थ्रू दिस पावर पॉइंट प्रेजेंटेशन. आई हैड ऑलरेडी पोस्टेड टू पावर पॉइंट्स इन द गूगल क्लासरूम. आई होप यू people have gone through it. Anyway, I will be explaining those points in details. So we'll go to that PowerPoint. First, the aims and objectives of NCC and the evolutions of NCC. NCC with an aim for raising a second line of defense and to create a large pool of trained youth available for armed forces during the First World War. The university corps were conceptualized by the British government. In India, NCC was raised with an aim of grooming both the boys and the girls, nurture them and direct them their energy towards nation building by making them responsible citizens. So this class will be to acquaint the students about the evolution of NCC, how NCC has evolved at the present stage. So the genesis of National Cadet Corps goes to the World War First, that was in 1917 to 1919. So that the British period, the Indian Defence Force Bill was passed in the Parliament on 21 February 1917, and it became an act on 28 February 1917, and the name was given as University Corps. So that is where the National Cadet Corps genesis was started. So initially, in 1917, it was known as University Corps. So this chapters will go through four parts. First part will be regarding University Corps. Second part is University Training Corps. Third part is University Officer Training Corps. And the fourth part is National Cadet Corps. The first part, the University Corps. As I have already mentioned, in 1917, by an act of parliament, it was passed. The main objective was to train potential soldiers for the British Army. So the University Corps did not include schoolboys. The training staffs were from the army. The medical test of students were conducted, and then military training on platoon basis were given. The training in drill, musketry, route marches and field manoeuvres was given. Then later on it was converted into University Training Corps. The University Corps was replaced by the University Training Corps. The name was changed, but the aim was same, was to provide officers for the British Indian Army. So bill approved on 22nd September 1920. So the University Training Corps was raised in 1921. Battalions commanded by the lieutenant colonels from teaching staffs. The teaching staffs were trained and was given the rank of lieutenant colonels. It was a uniformed organization like army. No wartime commitment was given and it was voluntary. The intake of University Training Corps cadets was voluntary. Companies commanded by majors from teaching staffs. Then adjutants, captains from regular army was given. The training syllabus was physical training, bayonet training, ceremonial drill, musketry. Then came the third part, the University Officers Training Corps. it was in the World War II, there was a need for a new phase of the university training corps as university officers training corps. So in 1942, university training corps molded on the lines of officer corps of UK, renamed as university officers training corps. The additional units, Indian Air Training Corps was also raised, Sea Scouts Corps was also raised, Women Auxiliary Corps was also raised. Each university had a unit. Indianization of the armed force was begun by then. By 1946, there were 18 university officers training corps units located across India. Then the part 4, it is the National Cadet Corps. There was a Cadet Corps committee. The Indian manpower and supplies vital to the British war effort. Detailed analysis of university officers training corps not able to fulfill the requirement of providing sufficient officers. So in July 1946, a committee to study and make recommendations for the establishment of a cadet corps organization was stated. The aim was to explore the feasibility of introducing military training in schools and colleges to attract educated youth towards armed force. The composition was a joint secretary from War Office, so he was a chairman, then representatives of each from three services, that is Army, Navy and Air Force, four members from the Education Department. Kunsru Committee and NCC. So there was an interim government in September 1946. This appointed Pandit Hridayanath Kunsru. He was MLA. He was the chairman. And he was appointed on 29th September 1946. Just based on the recommendations by the committee, NCC came into being on 15th July 1948. The Parliament Act No. 31 of 1948 designated the National Cadet Corps Act 1948. First NCC units of senior division was there in September 1948. First four units of SW was July 1949. Air Wing came into being in 1st April 1950. A squadron each was erstwhile in Bombay and Calcutta. The naval wing was started on 1st July 1952. One unit of senior division was erstwhile in Bombay. This is the NCC flag. It first came in 1951. This is the present tricolor flag, which is came into being in 1954. The red color represents the army. The navy color represents the navy and sky blue color represents Air Force. And this is the logo where 17 flowers around the NCC, both in Hindi and English. So this is the NCC crest. There are 17 flowers representing 17 directorates. Two dots representing Officers Training Academy in Kamti and Women's Officers Training Academy in Gwalior. Red color, as I have told, for Army, Navy blue for Navy, and sky blue color for Air Force. The first song of NCC came in 1963, and it was Kadam Kadam Milke Chal. Then later on in 1976, the second song was introduced, that is Hum Sab Hindi Hai. But later in 1980, the present song came into being. It is known as Hum Sab Bharatiya Hai. You can hear this song a while.
Hum sab bhartiya hai. So the NCC in the new millennium, we have been going through 63 years of existence. There are 17 directorates, 99 group headquarters, 837 units. The Army had 700 units, Navy 73 units, Air Force 64 units. Two training institutes, one in Kamti, that is Officers Training Academy, another one in Gwalior, which is known as Women's Officers Training Academy. Today, NCC is the largest youth organization in the world with almost 15 lakhs cadets. So this is the headquarters, there, this is the organization, NCC organization. Headquarters of Director General NCC, it is situated in Delhi, headed by a Director General NCC of the rank Lieutenant General. Two additional director of the rank Major General or equivalent, and five brigades or director which have the rank Brigadier or equivalent. There are 17 state directorates which are headed by the Deputy Director General, Army 12, Navy 2 and Air Force 3 directorates. There are 99 group headquarters, Army 89, Navy 4, Air Force 6. There are 837 units, where are 700 Army units of Infantry Battalion, Girls Battalion, Armored Squadron, Artillery Battalion, Signal Squad, Engineers Squad, Medical Battalion, Ramond and Veterinary Battalion, Electronics and Mechanical Engineers, Compo Koi, Boys Command Company, Girls Company, and there are Navy 73, Technical, Medical, Dockyard, Non-Technical, Air Force 2, Flying and Technical, that total 64. So there are 837 units. Then there are two training units, OTA Gwalior and OTA Kamti. He is the Director General of NCC, the present Director General of NCC, Lieutenant General Tarun Kumar H. He is the 33rd DG, an alumnus of National Defence Academy and Indian Military Academy. He is the Deputy Director General NCC of Tamil Nadu, Puducherry and Andaman Nicobar Directorate. His name is Commodore Malai K. Kukruthi. Tamil Nadu, Puducherry and Andaman Nicobar Directorate has 6 groups, Madras A, Madras B, Madurai, Tiruchirappalli, Coimbatore and Puducherry. Puducherry group headquarters have 8 units, 1 P Indepcoy, 2 P Indepcoy, 1 P Girls Indepcoy, 1 P Naval Unit, 1 P Air Squadron Unit, 4 TNCTC, 5 Tamil Nadu Naval Unit, 6 Tamil Nadu Battalion. So we will conclude this session here. So I will come with another PowerPoint about the aims and objectives of NCC. Thank you.